Hello everyone. After a long period of 3 decades, a big transformation to the Indian education system. It is the beginning of a new era in the education system of India, putting more emphasis on the practical knowledge on the part of the students rather than just achieving grades. So here we are with the most awaited reform in the education sector of India, that is the National Education Policy 2020. In this video, I'm going to take you through the highlights of the National Education Policy in very simple language, and we'll also try to cover a quick review of the important points mentioned in the policy. So let's begin with the main highlighting points. Mother tongue to be a medium of instruction till the 5th grade. School curriculum to be reduced to core concepts. The vocational education will be integrated from class 6. Report cards will be a comprehensive report on skills and capabilities instead of just giving marks and statements. Board examinations to be based on knowledge application. There will be a common entrance examination to be conducted by the National Testing Agency, that is NTA, for admission into universities and all higher education institutions. All higher education institutions except legal and medical colleges will be governed by a single regulator. MPhil courses to be discontinued under this new education policy. There will be common regulations for both the private and public higher education institutions in the country. Public investment in education sector to reach 6% of GDP at the earliest. Online self-disclosure based transparent system for approvals in place of inspections. More online courses will be developed in regional languages, virtual labs to be developed, and a national educational technology forum to be created under this new education policy. The new policy seeks to expand access to higher education for 50% of high school students by 2035. At least 3.5 crore new seats will be added to higher education institutions. The Union Cabinet also approved changing the name of the Ministry of Human Resource Development to Ministry of Education. Now, let's see what are the important points mentioned for school education in the National Education Policy 2020. There are a number of good things mentioned in the National Education Policy 2020 for school education. First of all, we have to mention that the early childhood care education, whose syllabus will be prepared by NCERT for children of age group between 3 to 6 years, will talk about giving more emphasis on activity-based learning rather than rote learning, and how numerical ability, logical ability, etc. will be developed among the children of such tender age group. Next, a national mission on foundational literacy and numeracy will be set up with a target that by the end of class 3, the learners should be able to develop a foundational mathematical ability. The next big point is that from now onwards, there has come to an end of the existing 10 plus 2 pattern, and instead of this, a 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4 pattern curricular and pedagogical structure will be followed. That means 5, that is initially 3 years of preschooling, that is before going to the formal school period, then up to class 2, then next from class 3 to class 5, then from class 6 to class 8, and finally from class 9 to class 12. Now, in the category from class 9 to class 12, the main important focus point would be that the students from class 9 onwards will be able to choose a combination of subjects as per their preference, irrespective of the stream. However, there is still lack in clarity whether these combinations will be fixed and pre-decided by the school, or there will be flexibility on the part of the student. Then, moving on, there will be no rigid separation between arts and sciences, between curricular and extracurricular activities, or between vocational and academic streams. For example, if a student of science is equally interested in music, then now the student can choose both science, say physics and chemistry, along with music as the combination of subjects. But earlier, these things were not like this. See, for example, a student of science stream was always confined to taking a combination of, say, physics, chemistry and mathematics, or biology or statistics as a combination. But now, the students will have the liberty to choose subjects as per their interest, which is indeed a very, very good thing for the new generation. Then there is a very good provision for the gifted children, that is those children having a very high degree of general mental ability in a specific area of activity or knowledge, that such children should be promoted. And this kind of promotion may be either through financial help or by helping them to get admission to good institutions which may be specialized for them. Moving on to the next point. The board exams will be set up in such a way that it will test the core concepts and application of knowledge by the learners. And for that, both objectives as well as descriptive questions will be included in the exam. And of course, this is a kind of preparation for taking the students to a higher level, a very, very important and good point. Another important point that National Education Policy 2020 has brought for us is that vocational training will be integrated from class 6 onwards. That is, students from class 6 onwards can now go to a, say, plumber or electrician or craftsman, a cutting, knitting, goldsmiths, etc. for, say, 10 days as under an internship project to learn about various activities of their interest. This is definitely a very good move by the government. Next, the curriculum of the school will be reduced to core concepts only. That is, no more heavy school bags for the little children again. Mother tongue or regional language to be the compulsory medium of instruction till 5th grade and preferably till 8th grade and above. After that, the report card of a student will be now treated as the profile of that student. That means, what is your friend's opinion about you, your likings and dislikings, what do you think about yourself, and what's your teacher's opinion about you, all these will be included and counted in your report card now. Then, every student or every child will have to come out of school adept in at least one skill. That is, when a student completes class 12, he should come out as an expert in at least one such skill which he can employ in his life as a survival option. Then there is a provision for National Professional Standards for Teachers, NPST, which will include training of teachers, categorization of teachers, or maybe even grading of teachers at per national standard. Children develop their habits by class 3 or class 4. Book reading is considered as one of the best habits for growing into a sensible citizen. The National Education Policy 2020 provides a very good opportunity for developing this habit in the form of book promotion policy and digital libraries, under which the students up to class 3 will have to learn read books, and the teacher should also encourage the students to read books. This is in fact a very good step, and I'm sure that it will prove to be a fruitful decision for the next generation if implemented properly. Now let's see what other important points mentioned for higher education in National Education Policy 2020. The first big point under higher education reforms is multiple entry and exit. That means, within the college tenure of 3 to 4 years, if a student wants, he can take a break for, say, 1 year after completing 1 year of his course and then again come back and continue rest of his course to get the degree. However, such academic gap has to be predetermined by the institution. The system is like your bank account only, that whatever you earn in the form of academics or vocational or co-curricular will be added to your academic credit. Moreover, if you complete 2 years out of a 4 years course, then it will be considered equivalent to a diploma. Again, If you achieve industry standard after completing 3 years of the course, then maybe you can join a job equivalent to that level. Also, the fourth year of any course will be research oriented. That is, the students will have to do a dissertation or research in a particular topic. Next, all the programs in the colleges will be multidisciplinary. For example, a student of mathematics honors can now add music or fine arts to his combination of subjects out of his interest without losing his academic credibility. Such act will also provide scope to local musicians or craftsmen or any other vocational practitioners to be associated with the mainstream education, which is a very good thing. Then, there will be a common entrance examination for the admission to all higher educational institutions, which will be conducted by NTA, that is National Testing Agency. The next important point is the provision of graded autonomy. For example, if an institution is at B category at present, then it needs to improve its grade to A category. Similarly, the A category institutions will have to upgrade themselves to A plus category and so on. If any institution fails to follow these instructions repeatedly, then such institutions will be phased out or their affiliation will be discarded over a period of 0 to 15 years. The National Education Policy 2020 also talks about setting up of a National Mission on Mentoring, MMM. Through this, a forum will be created with experts from every field or every sector who will work as a mentor for numerous students who tend to drop their dreams in between due to lack of proper guidance or motivation. Now, this again sounds to be a very noble move by the government. Moving ahead, the standard of education will be common to all. There will be a fixed fee cap for all category of institutions, be it public or private. That means, beyond that fee cap, no institution can collect an extra amount from the students. National Education Policy 2020 also talks about setting up of a National Research Foundation, NRF. As you might know that countries like USA have a NSF, that is National Science Foundation, which supports research activities in the field of science and also grants fund to such researches. But in India, NRF will not only be confined to science-based researches, but also to researches related to social science, financing, etc. Thus providing a wider scope in the field of research in general. In simple words, the main function of NRF will be to finance the research projects. The next point under higher education reforms is internationalization of education. That is, under this scheme, foreign students can come to India to get the same standard of education at a lower cost as they would get in their own country. This will help promoting Indian culture worldwide and will also help in boosting our economy. National Education Policy 2020 also talks about digitally equipping schools, teachers and students. Technology to be used in education planning, teaching, learning and assessment, administration and management and in regulation. Emphasis is given on creating e-contents in regional languages. This will also work as a part of the National Mission on Mentoring. So, these are the big points that are mentioned in the National Education Policy 2020. Some of these points are targeted to be achieved by 2023, while some other are targeted to be achieved by 2030. And if all the points are implemented properly, then it must be said that this will be the biggest transformative change in the Indian education system. Thank you for watching the video. If you like it, please share it. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, then please subscribe to it for never missing any updates on education, technology, and infotainment.